a much better stepping stone with a couple better results versus Japan and Tonga. This Samoan side, as we talked about, Luke, their professional side, they're going to the World Cup with hope. They bring their best side here. And the problem for Samoa tonight is staying focused with the task at hand with Canada and not looking forward to Monday's potential final against the Fijians.
Well, as for Canada, they make 12 changes to the starting lineup today. Only Moonlight, Ardron and Evans stay in from the side that lost against Tonga in Burnaby on Friday night. Evans moves to left wing after playing fullback against Tonga. And James Pritchard is back for his first action of this year's BNC.
Yeah, Phil McKenzie moves to the wing. And in the centers, we see Nick Blevins and Connor Traynor. Last week, Connor Braid, McKenzie moved into the centers for Kieran Hearn when he went out with a leg injury. I thought they tackled terrifically the whole night, and the Canadian centers tonight better have their tackling boots on because the Samoans are going to run right at them.
There is a late change on the bench. Aaron Carpenter, who scored a couple of tries on Friday, was supposed to get the night off. 7 minutes ago, he was still in street clothes, but there was a problem with Richard Thorpe after the warm-up, so Thorpe is off the bench, and Aaron Carpenter comes in. Kickoff will follow the anthems.
Presents today's match ball to referee Angus Gardner. Now we ask that everyone please rise, remove your hats, and join a special and proud guest, Mr. Salatua, in the singing of the Samoan National Anthem, and Rugby Canada's own event manager, Ms. Jennifer Smart, in the singing of the Canadian National Anthem.
Samoa tula e masese alafua olopalelea. Samoa tula e masese alafua olopalelea.
strong and free from far and wide. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Stand on guard for thee. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Well, Well, after losing the first two matches, the Canadians will be playing in the fifth against sixth game when this tournament wraps up in Burnaby at Swan Guard Stadium on Monday against the United States. But so important, Brian, for them moving forward right now that they put in a full 80-minute performance against Samoa, if possible.
Imperative. They put in an 80-minute shift tonight. Too much of this. We did this well. We did that well. We did 20 minutes well. They have to bring it tonight against a tough, tough opponent.
Is the Samoan Siva Tau. Samoans provide a challenge for Canada. 12 changes to that starting lineup that we saw just a few moments ago, Brian. Any surprises?
Well, I don't think that was a punishment to the boys who lost in Burnaby. It's Rugby World Cup time. The team will be announced next week. And Coach Crowley's made changes to look at different people. There are many spots still up for grabs. I'm sure his management team have compiled who they think will be in the mix, but there are certain spots that are up for grabs, and also the sevens team will be announced as well.
Evan Olmsted making his test debut tonight. We just saw him previously there.
And he's one of the gentlemen in the second row that is certainly in the mix, and with a big showing tonight, could make Kieran Crowley's decisions for the Rugby World Cup forwards even more difficult.
Canada ranked 18th against 9th ranked Samoa, and Nathan Hirayama will get things underway here just a couple of weeks after winning gold with Canada's Pan Am Games sevens team. Hirayama and Moonlight back here today amongst a number of players who were involved in that sevens team.
White
the
six.
Kick long downfield, Hirayama underneath it for Canada. Off he comes to James Pritchard, who is just three short of 600 points for his country. Bill McKenzie tackled just short of halfway. Now Hirayama out for Moonlight. And the tackle comes in from Afamasaga for Samoa. This is Doug Wooldridge. That gets it off for Hirayama. Out to the left through the hands there of James Pritchard. Here's Duru. And the referee tonight, Angus Gardner, the Australian-born 30-year-old.
Great start by Canada, and this will calm the nerves with Pritchard coming up to take a shot at goal. Great possession. They retain the ball. Spin it wide. We see Pritchard's numbers. Gareth Reese, Bobby Ross, Mark Wyatt, Jared Barker. But it's Pritchard's penalty would put him on an even 600 points. 60 caps, and by my math, that's 10 points a game.
He must be good at math.
Nice to see him in the lineup. They need some veteran leadership tonight. I think the boys are feeling the tension. A few of the stalwarts not around due to injury, people like Cudmore and Nanyak Dalla and Jeb Sinclair, but it's great to have Pritchard in the lineup, and all the boys look up to him, and if he can put this through, the Canadian cause will feel a lot more confident.
Certainly some key pieces missing for Canada right now. Some fitness worries heading into the last month before the World Cup. James Pritchard goes for 600 points, and he is successful. Canada off to an early lead from the boot of James Pritchard. Now the 20th player in test history to reach 600 points.
And has a nice career in Bedford, England. A great servant of Canadian rugby and a great kicker.
Caught by Tyler Ardron. Ardron bursting forward. Bright start this from Canada. Still in the very early stages here as Phil Mack gets the ball out to the left. Ray Barkwell hurrying across for the line out. He turns 35 next month. This is his 19th cap, a Niagara Falls native. First appeared for his country back in the fall of 2012.
And we actually have an all-Ontario front row for Canada this evening. Something very unusual. Doug Woolbridge back at Tighthead. A Lindsay, Ontario product. Sears Duru at Loosehead. Barkwell at Hooker. And this is bad news with Tyler Ardron down.
Is that good?
Being attended to.
Tyler Ardron, the captain for Canada. Here's how he got hurt. Powerful run forward. From the Ospreys man. The good news for Canada is he will be okay to continue.
No good? No good.
Or maybe he won't.
Yeah, when he went down the tackle, it looks like his left knee might have taken a strain. And I would think if he's not right, you get him off the field.
So four at the front, all talk, and 15th captain. Okay, all the best.
So Tyler Ardron is coming out.
Let's hope that's precautionary with the Rugby World Cup around the corner.
Come on.
I'm sure he might soldier on if this was a Rugby World Cup game.
Number eight's going on.
But he's not right, and James Pritchard will now be captain. And Canadians will be making a change. Aaron Carpenter's up. 15 minutes ago, he was probably looking forward to tucking into a sandwich, and now he might be on for a long shift.
Send him straight on.
It's not. It's Carpenter. DeGoody is in.
Okay,
son of the famous Canadian captain, Hans DeGoody, in for his second cap. He played against Japan. And as disappointing as this is for Tyler Ardron, it's exciting times for DeGoody.
Dad Hans was in the stands in San Jose to see him make his test debut in that game against Japan. Now DeGoody gets his chance here at BMO Field tonight. Carried by Matt Evans. Phil Mack off for Barkwell. Hirayama. Now Mack on halfway with a little chip kick forward. Picked up by Paolo. Out it comes from Matu.
Get back up, let's go, get back up.
Samoa with a win and a tie from their opening two games. Canada with the advantage of Barkwell here down the right side, and the play from Clevins. The offloads, and Canada might be in the corner. Phil McKenzie. The referee asks if it went forward. The answer is it did. So it will be no try. He called a forward pass.
The referee spoke to his assistant referee, and the ball did bounce forward on the pass. And it's going to come back, and the referee's playing advantage for the original infraction. And Canada will be awarded the penalty rather than the try. And I'm sure Pritchard may take a shot. Very unlucky by Canada right there. It did go forward. It looks like the right call. And they're electing to go for the lineup. Canada's looking very confident. I thought Ardron coming off might take the wind out of their sails a bit. They look very confident, very poised. And the Samoans are on their heels a bit right now.
Okay, let me go. No, the next time it happens, mate. Thank you.
Barkwell at the line-out. Won by Olmstead.
Vantage 8 the side. Play on.
Quickly taken here as Mack comes away with it. Looking out towards the left side. Quick hands. Canada might be in. Stretching for the line. It was Connor Traynor.
Another knock on by Canada. Fast hands. When you see Phil Mack play 15s, he plays it like he plays 7s. He's a swashbuckling guy. Wants to get the ball out. He ran the fast penalty. The ball went left.
Try stands.
The try stands.
The try is good.
It went off the leg. And the referee awards the try for Canada. Nick Blevins is the man to score. Did go off his knee.
Went off his kneecap and he collected it. And the try is good. And the Samoans are rattled. Convert to come.
Great call. Really good.
Nick Blevins with his third try for Canada on his 21st cap. Made his debut against Japan back in 2009. Canada off to a good start, as was the case in Burnaby on Friday.
And we've seen this all too often where Canada gets out of the gates. We saw it against Ireland. We saw it against the Maori All Blacks. We've seen it many times where the last 20 minutes jumps up and bites them. It's early days here. They look very confident. They look very efficient. They have to keep it going because Samoa's not going to go away.
James Pritchard to make it a 10-point lead. It looks good. It is. James Pritchard successful with the boot. And Canada up 10-0 after just 8 minutes against Samoa. Here's another look at the try. First off, it was Connor Traynor, and then Nick Blevins crossing the line. And there's the reaction from Blevins after the referee's decision.
This is a really important 5 minutes for Canada right now. They have a 10-point lead. They've got to keep it going. Samoa's going to ramp it up. They've got to maintain their ball in contact. Just keep doing the simple things. Minimize the mistakes.
A long kick downfield from Hirayama. Hirayama takes it on the 22. Pritchard with a long kick downfield. Hirayama keeps it in play, just short of halfway now with Canada. Spring in their step after the early scores. Here's Phil Mack, who has looked lively early on. Blevins, the try scorer. Mack managing to get that ball back towards Moonlight. And Mack trying to kick forward.
Knock on.
Referee calling a knock on. Real pace about Canada in the early stages, and Phil Mack's been involved in a lot of that.
Phil Mack, he's not just a facilitator at number nine, he creates things, and he's always in the defense's face. Yep. He's spreading things, he's got the great spin pass, and the Canadians, I can't say enough how confident they look, how organized they look. But what we're going to see after this injury is a very important facet of this game, Luke. We're going to see the scrummage. The Canadian scrum has to be solid. They have to give the back line a platform. As the game wore on in Burnaby, it all unraveled. And this Canadian pack have been doing the hard work. They've been breaking down the video. They have to win their own ball and service this back line.
Well, it's a familiar position for Canada. Just a few nights ago in Burnaby, they were up 10-0 after 10 minutes against Tonga. They ended up losing 28 points to 18. Earlier on today, the United States beaten by Tonga, 33-19. And just before this one, Fiji with a 27-22 win against Japan. It's Motu Matu'u who is down, the Wellington-born hooker. Made his debut in the Pacific Nations Cup opener against the United States. first start against Fiji, and he gets the call of Hooker again tonight. Ratu. And Canada with the lead, despite having to make a big change early due to the injury to Tyler Ardron.
Let's hope that was a precautionary move. Getting him off the field with so much rugby coming up in the very near future.
Bind! Set! Still! Stand up.
Phil Mack, the scrum half, getting set to put this in from Victoria, BC.
Both back square.
Scored a try here in the sevens final to win Pan Am Gold against Argentina. Nathan Hirayama also scoring a try in that final against Argentina.
Harry Jones said it was the greatest weekend of my life. Thank you, Toronto, and the fans were wonderful. And it was a very, very special weekend for Canadian rugby.
Hirayama describing it today as the best moment of his career so far in front of 20,000 here at BMO Field. Just a couple of weeks ago, here's Pritchard. Canada up to halfway.
No advantage.
Canadians have the Samoans unglued a bit here. If they keep it up, you know, we talked about Tonga can be undisciplined.
Yeah, so
the South Pacific teams like things going their own way, and when you disrupt them, when you get in their face a bit, it can cause adversity and a bit of finger pointing. And this is not the way the script had this one figured out in the first 11 or 12 minutes. And if Canada can get down the Samoan end, put a little more pressure on them, maybe feed off a couple of stakes, if they can punch something else over, this whole thing could unravel for the Samoans pretty quickly.
Referee chatting with Alassana Tuilagi. He plays for Newcastle Falcons. The Tuilagi brothers, of course, pretty famous in the rugby world. Six of seven brothers have played internationally, five for Samoa, one for England.
Only one brother didn't play.
Still a Samoan player down receiving treatment.
Thank you, Captain. Canada option.
What will Canada do here?
Well, I would think they would put it to touch. They would put it to touch, take the line out.
Yep.
Nathan Hirayama looks like he's totally business tonight.
Going for touch.
And you can really tell players like Hirayama, Phil Mack, John Moonlight, they all have that sevens touch to them. They're always trying to make something out of nothing. And that's a great clearance. Canada lineout attacks on here.
Fantastic kick from Hirayama. 10 meters out. This lineout now for Canada. Pele Kaui, the Samoan player down injured. One of a number of New Zealanders in the starting 15 for Samoa. By Barkwell, one by Olmsted. Matt gets it out for Hirayama. Now it's Connor Traynor. Matt once again for Hirayama. Canada trying to get some numbers down the left.
That might be a yellow card. That was a high tackle right around the throat, and it is.
It is.
That's the right call. Samoa's unraveled here. Canada, 10 minutes with a yellow card.
Yeah, I know.
And I can't say enough about McKenzie's game. Coming in early for Kieran Hearn the other night in Burnaby.
Yeah.
I thought him and Connor Braid were spades in the centers. Big tackles. He's featuring tonight on the wing. I thought Matt Evans was quite good under the high ball. He's on the other wing. Obviously, Pritchard at fullback. Canadian backline looks pretty solid to this point.
Paul Perez catch the yellow card. He had a couple of tries in the 30-30 tie against Fiji.
Well, the penalties keep accumulating for Samoa here. And if the Canadians can just keep it up, they've got 10 minutes with a yellow card. Pritchard's penalty to come to make it 13-0. And it's been all Canada so far.
Pritchard with 5 points so far tonight. Neither of his previous kicks have been easy.
And another really good kick from James Pritchard. 8 points on the night already as he sees his first Pacific Nations Cup action of the tournament. Canada extends the lead to 13 points. Taken by Kyle Gilmore. Just signed a one-year deal with Rotherham Titans in the second tier of professional rugby in England. Minutes in, Canada with the advantage. And a man advantage right now as well.
They have to go for the throat. They have to try and get more points while they have this advantage. They just can't rest on this lead because Samoa's going to come even 14-15.
Pritchard collects the kick. There's a Samoan man down as well.
Right now, Canada basically two players up. Barquill. Now it's Phil Mack.
Go, 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 go!
And there's space on the left for Canada. Connor Trainer couldn't get away. Here's Duru now. Canada, Olmstead coughs it up and Barquill tries to get there. Hiriamu goes in but it won't count.
It's all Canada right now, Luke, and very unlucky. The ball went forward. It's going to be a Samoan scrum, but Samoa definitely rattled. Philly Mack puts the ball out. Connor Trainer, shoestring tackle. And here it is right there. The big man spills it. Barkwell collects it. It went forward. Whistle goes. Canada still have Samoa under pressure.
It looks as if Pele Kauli is going to have to come out of the game. 22-year-old Western Suburbs player. Forced off with injury.
Canada's got a bit of swagger right now. They feel very confident for a team that's dropped games to Japan and Tonga. Feeling very good about themselves. Very entertaining game. The fans are having a great time. If they can stick one in on Samoa now, they could really, really unravel this side and take it forward.
So Kauli with the arm injury forced off 15 minutes into this match with Samoa trailing and Canada in a really good position right now. Canada also with the man advantage.
Set.
But Samoa with the put in at the scrum. Laboa Femi.
There it is.
So Kauli, the scrum half, forced off and replaced by Afemi, the 23-year-old. And it's down for James Pritchard, who collects inside his own 22. Pritchard, who has been perfect with 3-for-3 kicking tonight, goes long towards the Samoan 22. And that's into touch. A really positive start for Canada as they face ninth-ranked Samoa, looking for their first points of the 2015 Pacific Nations Cup.
I don't think Phil McKenzie agreed with the touch judge's ruling where the lineout should have been. He had thoughts of going fast, getting the ball back in play with Canada being up 15-14. That extra body means so much.
If you are just joining us, Tyler Ardron forced off early in this one, Canada's captain. And a change before they even started on the bench after warm-ups, with Richard Thorpe going off with an injury and Aaron Carpenter exchanging his street clothes for his rugby kit just a few moments before kickoff. He's on the bench.
Nick Blevins with the only try so far. 7 minutes in, James Pritchard with a conversion and two penalties, and Canada leads.
McKenzie takes his man to touch. The Canadians still applying pressure. And we've been quick to criticize the referees in a few of the games. We have to commend the official. He spoke to his touch judge about the try. They agreed it had gone off Blevins' knee. They made the right call. He collected the ball even though it went forward off his knee, and they awarded the try.
Initially it looked as if it would be a knock-on, but the Sydney-born referee Angus Gardner got it right. Samoa in the blue and white up towards halfway. It's been mostly Canadian possession through 18 minutes so far here at BMO Field. And the referee awards that to Canada.
Canada almost counter-rucked and stole the ball. Nevertheless, the Samoans knocked it on. Canadian scrum. It's all going Canada's way right now.
Mark. Let's have a look at that side, Dutch. Number two. Let's go, please. A little bit quicker to form up.
You know, from a coaching standpoint, you almost want to break things down and keep it simple. And
guys, I need you guys
break it down into four 20-minute quarters. Canada's getting out of the first quarter. Couldn't have gone much better. They have a 13-0 lead. Now they have to address the second quarter, taking it into the half. They have to keep it going. They have to maintain a steady scrum. The tackling's been good. They look very organized in the back line. Just keep it going.
About 3 minutes left with the man advantage for Canada before Paul Perez comes back in. In it goes at the scrum from Phil Mack. And Canada loses that, but the referee goes to the whistle.
Loose head angle. Loose head.
The scrum screwed there, and the Canadians are being awarded the penalty. The penalty count is very one-sided. The Samoans being very undisciplined. Canada has to keep it going, keep that scrum steady.
Midway through the first half here at BMO Field in Toronto, as Hirayama kicks to touch, and the line-out will be just outside the 22. Ray Barkwell will take it.
And we have to mention here, Luke, this is the Samoan side on July 8th, 2.5 weeks ago, ran the All Blacks very close, 25-16. And they're the real deal, totally professional outfit. Canada's had their way with them for the first quarter of this game.
Move six.
In Samoa, they called it the test that stopped the nation just a few weeks ago against the All Blacks.
Offside.
New Zealand winning it 25-16, although their cash-strapped offside Samoan red. Rugby union losing $1.5 million on that game, and their Prime Minister saying this week that they spent much more than they managed to get back from staging that test against the All Blacks. But an impressive display nonetheless from Samoa, who will be in Pool B at the Rugby World Cup when it kicks off in September, live on TSN, along with South Africa, Japan, Scotland, and the United States.
And Samoa are in Pool B to go through. They're not in there to compete, they're in there to go to the quarterfinals. And with matches against Scotland and Japan, they would be the odds-on favorite to do so behind this
red box. There'll be no numbers. There's no numbers, don't worry.
And it comes from Matu. Samoa up to the 22. It's the first time we've really seen any kind of pressure.
It stopped once.
Inside Canada's half.
Use it now. Good. Number 20 unbinding and coming in the side.
It's Tyson Dagoody penalised by the referee.
20 red side entry.
Tyson Dagoody's father, former captain of Canada, Hans Dagoody, led Canada in the 87 World Cup with a young teenager named Gareth Rees playing number 10. Hans Dagoody is one of the hardest men that's ever put on the red jersey, and he is just beaming with the success of his son.
Tyson Dagoody spoke in San Jose after making his debut about just what it means to him to follow in his father's footsteps as well, and just to have a chance right now of getting into Canada's World Cup squad.
He's one of those young men that is making the coaching staff's the coaching staff's decisions very difficult moving forward to the World Cup. you take in a veteran who may not get a lot of minutes, or you take a youngster in that's going to go to Japan in 2019 and let him gain the experience of England 2015. Very, very difficult decisions next week. 31 boys will be chosen. Some very tough choices at hand.
Michael Stanley, the Auckland-born fly half, to try and get Samoa on the board. His first attempt of the night. And it's good from Michael Stanley. And the Samoan deficit is cut to 10 points.
That was very big for the Samoans. It's been Canada's game with possession. It's been Canada's game with territory. It's been Canada's game with points. And to get some points on the board to cut into the lead, imperative for Samoa.
Michael Stanley only making his debut for Samoa last November against Italy. Plays his club rugby with Ulster in the Pro 12. And here comes Samoa breaking up towards halfway. Good tackle by James Pritchard to stop the run. But they might have the numbers out to the left here. This time, the tackle comes in from the try scorer for Canada, Nick Blevins, to ensure the Samoan charge is halted.
The Canadians have elected, both in Burnaby and this evening, on their restarts to kick the ball deep. We saw in Burnaby DTH Van der Merwe chasing the ball. We saw Tyler Ardron chasing the ball. But when you kick a ball off a kickoff 35 meters deep, it's hard to get pressure on your opposition. And in that situation, the Samoans counterattacked it, chipped it down the field.
Moonlight winning it from the line out, and the kick forward by Phil Mack, chased towards halfway there by Phil McKenzie. Once again, Canada's tackle is strong down the Samoan left.
No, blue ball.
It's a blue ball. But there seems to be a lot more pace about Canada when Phil Mack is on the pitch.
I think the defense has to respect what he can do. And until he passes the ball, he's always a threat to run. He's like a water bug around the base of the scrum, and he wants to run. And as I said earlier, you can tell he's a sevens player. He's always looking for a seam. He's always looking for a gap, and he wants the defense on their heels.
Duru with the tackle on Paradisi. Justice Sears Duru.
Come on.
Relatively new to the international scene. Just a few caps for Canada, even though he made his debut back in 2013. The Oakville native coming on for the last 9 minutes against Tonga in Vancouver on Friday night.
Stay straight. Get rewarded.
There hasn't been many set pieces, but the Canadian scrum does look better tonight. They have to keep that going as the night wears on and the fatigue wears in. And that heat, they'll start to feel it. The scrummage is imperative for Canada. They have to have a solid platform.
Okay. Yes. He's in.
Motu Matu, the hooker for Samoa, puts it at the line out. Barkwell has to make the tackle. Samoa starting to look dangerous now as they carry this one forward. Canada has the advantage for a knock-on, and it's kicked downfield. The referee will pull this one back.
No advantage.
The advantage didn't accrue, so it's a Canadian ball.
Big break for the Canadians there. Samoa, for the first time in the game, really looked like a threat. You mentioned it, Luke, that they're coming into the game now, and it's imperative that Canada stand strong on defense, get the territory back, play the game in the Samoan end.
Let's go.
The referee just asking the Samoans to form up quicker in the scrum.
Hold away.
Angus Gardner's fifth year as a full-time pro referee, started age 25. Canada with this Crouch. Put into the scrum just inside their own 22.
Bind! Set!
Go, brought away by Kyle Gilmore.
Inside.
Kicked by Hirayama, charged down by the Samoans.
Ray Barkwell dove right over that ruck. He was lucky he wasn't penalized. Got to keep your feet. Penalties have been disproportionate. The Samoans have had many. Canada seems to be playing the game on the front foot. They've got to get it going again as they approach the half.
Barkwell in towards Olmsted, but Canada will lose that ball. They pick it back up here. Hirayama with the kick downfield. Samoa back over halfway. Nathan Hirayama underneath it. Nicely done by Hirayama as he makes his way towards the halfway line here. 28 minutes in at BMO Field. Blevins. Blevins tackled just short of halfway. Out by Phil Mack. Now it's Tyler Hodson. Pritchard. And a trainer. Held up just short of halfway. Here's Doug Wooldridge from Lindsay, Ontario. Mack for Hirayama. Hirayama will kick long downfield, looking to send Samoa back pedaling. Another very good kick from Nathan Hirayama. That's the second time he has almost reached the corner flag. Perfect positioning.
He's having a terrific game, and he's just brimming with confidence. The Canadian back line making their tackles. They're trying to be constructive with the ball. They seem like they want to go at every opportunity, and that's very attractive for the fans. And I think it has the Samoans a bit unraveled, unglued, and they're not used to Canada taking it to them. I think they thought they were going to swagger in here and put it to Canada, and Canada's taking the game to them.
Samoa will kick towards halfway, where it's out of play. The Pacific Nations Cup will wrap up on Monday with the finals day in Vancouver, Burnaby, BC to be exact, at Swan Guard Stadium. Canada will be in the fifth against sixth game against the United States, but it's still to be decided who will be playing for first place against Fiji.
Well, if Canada wins this game, I think they could turn the tournament on its ear and maybe open the door to Tonga playing Fiji. This wasn't expected. There's a lot of rugby to be played, but that would be a huge statement by Canada if they can keep this going.
We're half an hour in here. It was the 35th minute when Canada led Tonga 15-3 at Swan Guard Stadium on Friday before that Liam Underwood yellow card and the Tonga comeback. Minutes before half time. And Samoa breaking through here. Good tackle, just short of the 22, and Canada will get possession. In the end, it bubbles away.
They had the turnover, they had it nicked, and the Samoans took it right back, and it's going to be a Samoan scrum. But Canada lucky that the Samoans didn't run roughshod into the end zone on that.
Babe Tuilagi, who plays for Carcassonne in France. One of the Samoan players on the charge.
Let's go, guys.
Samoa with a man down.
Out there, Luke, with this heat. Looks like the Samoan player may have a cramp.
Anthony Peronese, who's down, 32-year-old New Zealand-born prop. He plays for Bristol in the RFU Championship in England, the second tier of the pro game.
Former club of the great Al Sharon, the Canadian star player. Big scrum for Canada. They don't have to win the ball, but they have to contest, put some pressure on the Samoans, set their defense, and negate a scoring chance here.
Set! Still!
Samoa trying to run it here towards the Canadian 22. And then they spill it. That's a let off for Canada. Levins down the left. Phil Mack wanted to take it quickly.
Penalty's been awarded to Canada, but getting back to the Samoan run, the Canadian defense was set and the Samoans never had a chance. Terrific defense, terrific positioning, terrific tackling, and the Canadians have been awarded a penalty, and the Samoan problems continue.
Captain.
The referee calling over Alassana Tuilagi. Let's hear what he's got to say to the Samoan captain.
So, look, our issue now is we've got another penalty for no arms in the tackle. We've got another penalty for one of your guys, no arms in the tackle. You've just lost one to the bin. Okay, we're not going to back off as a team, okay? So this is your issue. You guys need to be more disciplined and deal with it, understand? Okay?
No,
I will, but you take on board the message. Right.
Excellent refereeing. Excellent refereeing. He's talking to the skipper. He's warning them about tackling without wrapping. The skipper came back with a question about the breakdown, and he didn't want to hear anything about it. He said, tell your players to wrap. No shoulder charges, and he's certainly taking charge. Angus Gardner, the Aussie, doing a great job to this point. And he's punishing the Samoans for their undisciplined play.
Picked up here by Kyle Gilmore on the Samoan 22. Now it's Connor Traynor. Moonlight gets it out towards Matt Evans, and this is Hirayama. Justice Sizduru. Back out for Hirayama. Now the tackle comes in on Nick Levins.
There it is. Turnover good.
And the ball turned over. Tyson Bagudi with the tackle there, forcing Samoa back. One of your big points before the game, Brian, was the fact that Canada, whatever the outcome, needs to put in a performance they're happy with through 80 minutes of play. 34 minutes in, so far so good.
Taking the player off
the ball. Barkwell is penalised here.
They would be delighted to take this lead into the half. The Samoans aren't going to go away, and they're going to put a big push on for the last 6 minutes, try and get something across to narrow this lead.
Get up!
I can't say enough about the Canadian commitment, though. Their tackling has been terrific.
Off the ball, number two.
And if this was to continue, some interesting questions posed by players out there tonight for Kieran Crowley, the head coach, who made 12 changes coming into this game.
Well, Kieran Crowley's line a couple weeks ago was, it's an opportunity for some of the boys to put their hand up for the Rugby World Cup, and I think that's exactly what's happening. And with some players' fitness being a question, some of the players that are not in this camp, there are certainly a lot of decisions to be made for Canada.
Canada winning the line out, and Moonlight skipping up towards halfway. On the couple of times Samoa has had possession deep in Canada's half, there's been an error by Samoa, affording Canada the opportunity to get away. Long chase on here, and out just by the corner there as was being chased down by Phil McKenzie. McKenzie getting into it.
Nathan Hirayama is kicking with his left foot. He's kicking with his right foot. All he is doing is rolling the ball out of bounds at the 5 or 8 meter line every time. He's having a blinder today.
McKenzie getting into it there with Alassana Tuilagi.
McKenzie would say no to nobody. He's always keen to go. The referees are having a word. But once again, this is Samoa.
I think we'll just play the original one. I'll just have a word to both captains, all right? Okay. Four. Captain. Yeah. Captain. Yeah. Okay, boys. Look, we've got a cracking game of footy here. Would you agree?
Yeah, mate. Yeah.
Okay. What we don't need is players pushing and shoving and running in, okay?
Yep.
We need to keep the discipline standards high. I've already had a talk to you. You're the captain. Let's lead by example, please. Okay.
All right.
Thank you. Yeah. Now, listen, with your guys, I've just had the one off the ball down here and then the retaliation by your man here, all right?
Okay, yes, yeah.
Let's just keep it under wraps, okay?
Okay.
Have a word to the guys.
A bit excited, yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
James Pritchard. Canada's captain now after Tyler Ardron went off. There you see a little shove by Phil McKenzie. And Alassana Tuilagi trying to get it back.
Yep.
McKenzie won't give an inch.
To lead by example.
Won't give an inch. And you know, you have to like what the referee did there. Had a good word, told the boys it's been a great game. And to sort it out.
Time on.
Time back on, 5 minutes before half time. Matu, the 28-year-old hooker.
Piffero is on for Ray Barkwell.
Here's a chance for Canada, having won it at the line-out. Kyle Gilmore trying to get forward. Hirayama then drops it. And it's a Samoan ball.
I'm not sure if Barkwell's injured, but he has come off. And Piffero's in at hooker. I think this is quite early for tactical substitution. Piffero did come in Burnaby for the two try score, Aaron Carpenter, and he's another young man who's making Kieran Crowley's selection committee's lives very, very difficult.
God, last gun was good, same again, stability, hold the weight.
That was a lost chance by Canada. You could see Hirayama just looking up. He knew the defense was closing, and despite having a terrific first half, that's a ball he'd love to have back.
Babo Afemi, the scrum half for Samoa, came on early in the game.
No, Stable is not going in, all right? Stable is holding the gap.
An injury to Pele Cowley, Samoa number 9. In the early stages of this game, it is 13-3 in favour of Canada. Nick Blevins scored the only try of the game, 7 minutes in. James Pritchard perfect with the boot. 8 points from him. Two penalties and a conversion. Samoa coming away with it, and the break is on here. Phil Mack trying to get back. And a challenge as well comes in from Nick Blevins. Put forward by Michael Stanley. Canada really needing to hold out Samoa until half time here. With just under 3 minutes left. Holding on the call.
Back 10.
Samoa getting a bit rattled. Canadians doing a terrific job in the tackle.
What about Phil Mack getting back to tackle as well?
Pound for pound, toughest guy in the field. He's got the heart of a lion.
Watch this.
He's not going to let the big man get away. That's all pro right there.
He's been superb in this first half.
We have to remember, a year ago in the PNC, the end of June in Sacramento, when Canada lost to the U.S. 38-35, Phil Mack had a major, major knee injury, which took him out of the seventh circuit for the entire winter. He's still working on his knee strap tonight.
In from Piffero. Mack gets it across for Hirayama. Bit of space here, Hirayama almost getting free.
Leave it blue!
Back out for Gilmore.
Back on side, blue. Step.
Justin Cisduro into the 22. Inside the final minute of the first half.
This is great stuff by Canada.
Max gets it out to the left. There's a chance here for James Pritchard. Rolls through the tackle. Canada keeps the ball. Now Olmsted. Held up 5 metres short. Mack looking to get his way through. An opportunity for Canada here to extend their lead just before half-time. Trying to run through, and then the knock-on.
Advantage over.
And the long kick downfield sends McKenzie chasing back. As we move past the 40-minute mark.
Canada will be disappointed with that.
It's half-time here at BMO Field, and Canada leads by 10. Brian.
From Vancouver to Toronto. And I was with the Canadian team after the Tongan loss, and it was a very somber group of men. And I'm sure that was a long flight, and they reset in Toronto. And quite frankly, the first 40 minutes did not play to script. And I think a lot of people are surprised, especially the Samoans, but it's imperative for Canada moving forward that they keep it up. We talked about them playing a full shift of 80 minutes. We've seen them in the past wilt in the last quarter of a game. They have to keep it going for 40 minutes, salvage something out of the PNC, move forward in a positive note for the Rugby World Cup.
Canada has never beaten Samoa. Their last meeting was last November when Samoa won 23-13 and Connor Traynor scored Canada's only try.
I like the way Canada's played. They look very organized. They look very confident. I said earlier, they have a little bit of swagger in their step. They're hitting the rucks very hard. And they've just got to keep it going. The game they've got going, just keep it up. Because Samoa has regrouped, and they're going to come back twice as hard as they did in the first half.
Hirayama with the kick. And Canada looking to pick it up here with Blevins.
Leave it!
Hirayama downfield. Ray Barkwell is back into the action.
And he's got a scrum cap on, and we didn't see what happened. It may have been a blood injury. Ray usually doesn't wear a scrum cap, and Piffero came in for him, and he's been attended to.
Canada having to defend at the start of the second half.
They're off their feet playing it.
Canada penalized for being off their feet.
Off his feet playing it. Relax, not every time. Line.
Stanley kicks to touch. And a big few moments here for the Canadians.
Absolutely. They don't want to come out and cough up a try in the first few minutes of this half and bring the Samoans back into the game. The Canadians want to dictate things, keep the Samoans rattled, keep the pressure up. The Samoans uncharacteristically are making a lot of turnovers. They're taking penalties. They're yipping at each other. Canada's got to keep it up.
Samoa 5 metres out.
Unbound.
The referee.
Unbound. Scrum.
Gives that the way of Canada.
Unbound.
He's giving them the put in. The Samoans weren't bound. And that's a huge, huge break for Canada.
There have been a couple of big moments for Canada in this game when Samoa has been inside the Canadian 22.
It seems Angus Gardner, Australian referee, hasn't missed any of them. He's been on top of things. He's had a couple good conversations with the skippers. He talked to Pritchard about a couple things he didn't like. He told him to tell Phil McKenzie to calm down a bit. And I think he's calling a good game. It happens to be leaning Canada's way, based on the Samoans being undisciplined.
Steal!
But Canada made 12 changes to the starting lineup today. Moonlight, Ardron and Evans, the only players staying in from the loss against Tonga in BC on Friday. Ardron left the game very early with an injury. And Tyson Dugudi coming in for his second cap.
Bind! Set!
5 metres from their own try line. Phil Mack gets it out from the scrum.
Here it is. No.
And Canada turns it over. Samoa in with the score.
Canada wants to play expansive rugby. That was an ill-advised pass. The cover was there. Canada should have cleared it off the scrum. Scrum was in trouble. Phil Mack collected the ball.
Yeah.
They chose to run the ball. Probably should have cleared it and reset in the lineout. And Samoa's right back in it. 13-8, Convert to come.
No!
Yeah, it looked like Canada had it. Just before that, off the scrummage, Phil Mack passed out. Maybe when he should have cleared the ball, even though the cover was very tight. Bit unlucky, and then the Samoans just walking.
So Samoa with their try, and it is Anthony Peronese, the player to cross the line. And we talked about the need for Canada to stay strong and keep Samoa out in the early stages of the half. They were unable to do so, and now Michael Stanley will look to make it a 3-point game. And the kick is good. It's 13-10, and it's very much game on here in Toronto.
I think this week, the players and the coaching staff for Canada would have taken this 13-10, 5 minutes into the second half. But the next 35 minutes, obviously, are gigantic for the Canadians moving forward.
Hirayama from the kickoff.
Samoa hit that ruck on the 22-meter line like they mean business. They're just been given a shot of life here.
Knock on
advantage. Canada from Hirayama. They seem to have a spring in their step, the Samoans, that wasn't there in the first 40 minutes of play. But is that a knock-on as well? It is.
Referee played advantage to Samoa. The advantage was over, and lucky for Canada, the ball was spilled. Canada can catch their breath. Hands are on the hips. It's hot out there.
Shoulders in, six. Crouch. Bind. Set. Stand up.
Yep. Angus Gardner not happy with the scrum.
Yep. Hold. Got extra step. Take the weight. No, take the weight. Hit and hold. Crouch! Bind! Set!
And it goes from Mack.
Balls out.
All the way to Trainer on halfway. He'll offload towards Hirayama. Quick hands from Canada. Pritchard with a kick forward. It's going to Canadians chase. And they'll keep Samoa inside their own 22. Out it comes there. Mafemi. Not being given by the referee.
Big chance for Canada. Perfect attacking position.
White number one off. Substitution.
Change here with Viliamu Afita going off. And coming in, it's going to be
scrum red.
Sakura Talufo.
Let's go, boys.
Stade Français, yeah, prop, former London Wasp.
You alright? No, I didn't, mate. I'm sorry. Sorry, mate.
Break here with the Samoan injury for the Canadians to regroup. Phil Mack having a word with Nate Hirayama. In comes Blevins. They're discussing what they might have on here. They have to have a solid platform run off this. So quick around the base of the scrum, Phil Mack is. It just opens up lanes, creates opportunity, and he can hit a gap so quickly. Draws in the defenders and has that nice long spin pass. Keeps the defenders honest, but it all starts with the scrummage move.
DJ Ione, the Samoan player down. He scored a try with 7 minutes to go against Fiji. He's the MVP of that game. As the Samoans forced to come back.
Crouch.
A great position here for Canada.
Set.
After an Anthony Ferranese try, pulled Samoa back into this game.
He's come across, guys. He's the mark. Go. Long binds, please, guys. Long binds.
Gilmore's back at number 8.
Crouch.
Moved back there when Ngudi came on. With Ardern off the field, you got to think they're going right and they have something on here.
Set. Still.
Wow, he's called the penalty against Canada. The scrum went down again.
Tight head angle.
A missed opportunity for Canada.
He's calling Doug Woolbridge. Tight head was on an angle. The scrum came down, the referee is determining it was Woolbridge's infraction that caused the scrum to come down. And Samoa's put it down the field, but they've missed their... No, they made their touch. Out of harm's way for now. The Canadian forwards have to pick it up. I think we'll see substitutions coming in. Piffero may come back in for Barkwell. Hubert Bidens will be coming in.
You guys set the numbers if you got one more at the end of the day, we're going to play on. Substitutions number 1, 2, and 3, Canada. Yeah, time's up.
Taking so says Duru, Barkwell, and Woldrich all going off.
On that one, your tight head just got completely demolished. Time on.
They're making three changes at once, 10 minutes into the second half. Tuolagi held up. Tackle coming in there from Tyler Hodson. Hodson came off the bench against Japan, didn't play against Tonga. Samoa make their way towards the 22. ball.
Tough defense again. Nick Levins made a big hit. Kyle Gilmore's having a big game. He's on the bottom of that. Tough defense by the Canadians.
Hirayama kicks for touch. A really good kicking performance from Nathan Hirayama in the first half tonight. Juvik Vaik came on late against Tonga. So Pifaro back in, having played at the end of the first half as well. Mack for Hirayama. Now it's Moonlight. Mack finally getting possession. Well done by Phil Mack. Now it's Hirayama. Not much space down the left wing. Canada turning the ball over. Inside from Paolo to Corey. And then the tackle from Connor Trainer.
Five open up. Thank you.
Canada gets the call.
Richard might have a shot at this. Canada turned the ball over, the Samoans collected it, and then Canada got it back. Now the decision is...
The one I'm seeing is Canada legally on their feet, able to contest the ball. No, I'm happy. The guy's there first.
Just where you are. Explaining his decision to Alassana Tuilagi. And James Pritchard will indeed go for goal. Richard with 3 for 3 tonight. 607 points on his career. Canada's last points coming in the 13th minute of this game. Pulled it wide. The first one missed by James Pritchard tonight. Aaron Carpenter is getting set to come in here. It remains 13-10 for Canada.
Yeah, not now, mate. Not now.
Aaron Carpenter in conversation there with Gareth Rees, the program manager. Carpenter scoring 2 tries on Friday night in Burnaby. Here's Matt Evans with the run along halfway. Now the kick forward from James Pritchard. The chase is on for Canada. Samoa finally collecting possession.
Good pressure by Canada. Samoa under siege there, and they cleared the ball.
White number 5 sub, red 20 sub.
Off goes Joe Tikori for Samoa.
Great hands by Ngudi. Pritchard chips through. Didn't get a Canadian bounce.
And it's Ngudi coming off now for Aaron Carpenter. Carpenter wasn't going to be in the squad tonight. Wasn't dressed for action until after warm-ups when Richard Thorpe went down with an injury. Carpenter, of course, has played a lot at number 8 before
playing hooker most of the last couple of years.
That will allow Canada to put Gilmore back as flanker. Carpenter will settle in at number 8 for the last 25 minutes.
His trainer down the left. Mac driving forward.
Stay on. Don't hold him.
Now it's with Pifferall. Canada giving up possession. Samoans kick downfield. Pritchard will chase. And it just stays in play. James Pritchard with the high kick forward. There's a Samoan player down. Some strong tackles coming in, and Canada wins it back, but then Carpenter couldn't find another red jersey. But it will be Canada scrum.
Yeah. Pritchard tried to sell a call. The referee wasn't buying it after he chipped forward. He did that. A modest bump by the Samoan. He went down. And then it all stops when the referee got in between the play. But it will be two things. Canada put in.
Come on now. Don't block players. Which one you
can. The referee warning there not to block players at the line out. The next one will be a penalty. Andrew Tiedemann getting warned there by referee Angus Gardner. Well, Canada still leads. The lead is smaller than it was at halftime. Kerenise, 3 minutes after the break, getting Samoa's only try. Nick Levins, the man to get Canada's try back in the 7th minute. James Pritchard with 8 points on the night.
Let's go, boys. Hold the way. We can play on, boys. Let's go.
A little over 20 minutes left to play. A win that would be massive for Canadian confidence. That has taken a bit of a beating in recent times, winning just 2 of the last 11 test matches back to November 2013, only beating Namibia and Portugal during that time. It's 2 wins in 13 if you include the games against the Maoris and the English Championship side.
Crouch.
So to take down a big name like Samoa would be a massive boost.
Set.
Canada up 13-0 after 13 minutes. And 45 minutes since they've failed to score. Samoa getting 10.
Just come a touch closer to the mark.
It's looking like Fiji will top the group Crouch. After the round robin stage. Go into the final as the first seed on Monday. Fiji with a 27-22 win over Japan earlier, after the Tongans got their second win of the tournament, beating the US. Mac for Hirayama. Out to the left, and good run here for Matt Evans. Knock on call.
Spill the ball forward, but that's Enterprise by Canada. They are trying to spread the ball.
Crouch! Fine! Set!
And it comes from a fly, mate.
Out the side tunnel. Let's go.
at the hour mark at BMO Field in Toronto in the final game of a Pacific Nations Cup triple header on TSN. Canada 20 minutes away from victory.
Nice and still. Crouch. Fine. Set.
Lawrence bringing it up to their own 22. They've been knocked out of the pool stage of the last three World Cups. They advanced to a quarter-final playoff back in 1999. Made the quarters in 95 and 91. Levins, who scored Canada's try. Hirayama will go for the drop goal. Nathan Hirayama. It's good from Nathan Hirayama.
22.
But did the referee call it off?
Called it not good. He stroked it with his left foot. From our vantage point, it was tough.
Number 9 and number 11 reds up.
Couple more changes here. Gordon McCrory and Harry Jones coming in. Let's have another look at this from Nathan Hirayama. Yeah. No, it was wide. Yeah. Pulled it well wide in the end.
Yeah. Let's go, time on.
So Phil Mack is out after a really good evening's work.
Wonderful game for Phil Mack. Really had the defense on their heels. Gordon McCrory comes in.
Canada with a couple of changes. McCrory and Jones both coming in.
Holding on.
This last 20 minutes has not been kind to Canada. On several internationals that we have covered with TSN over the last few years, really would be a big shot in the arm for the program moving
what are we doing?
The World Cup if they can hang in and take this one home.
Here it is.
Can't say enough about Phil Mack. I mentioned in the first half, Luke, pound for pound, I think he's the toughest player on the team. He showed it with his tackle. He showed it with his offense. He showed it with his heart. How can you not like and respect Phil Mack for what he does for Canadian rugby?
Yeah, let's just...
So influential with the sevens. And tonight, I think he gave Canada, and that performance early in this game, a new lease of life.
I think he keeps the defense honest because many stereotypical scrum halves are facilitators. They put the ball out. With Phil Mack, you don't know if he's going to go or not. And he's got the great fate. I've said before, around the base of the scrum, you don't know if he's passing or running. And he takes the ball on in contact, as he did a moment ago, wins the ball, made the tackle at the end of the first half. He's a complete player. And as I said, his teammates admire him very much.
Paolo back on his feet as Michael Stanley gets set. Take this kick. Oh, it's good from Stanley. This one is tied.
That's a big time kick by Stanley. This air is very muggy and that ball is very heavy. And he gave that a massive thump and it just crawled over the bar to tie this up at 13. But that is a world class kick right there.
He only kicked with a 50% success rate against Fiji. 7 points, 3 of 6. Former Saracens man has been on target tonight. 3 of 3. And we have ourselves a tied game with 16 minutes left to play here in Toronto.
And it looks like the Samoans just got a shot of adrenaline because they seem to be hitting the rucks harder, driving the Canadians off. They seem to be re-energized after that penalty to even the game up.
Play advantage, this side. side.
It's called the Canadians coming in from the side. And this kick is a couple meters longer than the last one, but he's going to go again.
No, it's just on the line.
So Michael Stanley with the chance to put Samoa in front for the first time on the night. Canada did lead by 13 points to nil.
Not sure if he's got this kick in his leg on a night like this where that ball's a wee bit heavier.
From halfway, Michael Stanley to give Samoa the lead. And he does. Super kicking from Michael Stanley. And Samoa leads for the first time tonight with 14 minutes left to play.
He hit that one better than the previous one. It was a few meters further out and it cleared the bar by 4 or 5 meters. Big time kicking by Samoa, have them in the lead 16-13.
It's a try apiece. Levins for Canada in the first half, Peranisi for Samoa just after half time. Stanley has kicked 4 of 4, Pritchard has kicked 3 of 4. And that is the difference right now. Just the one penalty. Pifro ready with the line-out. Man from Montreal. In it goes. Kuriyama. Now Carpenter. Out from McCrory to Hirayama. Then Trainer. And there's a knock-on from Canada from Harry Jones, I think.
Was Harry Jones. The pass was a bit behind him. He spilled the ball forward. Advantage Samoa. They're put into the scrum. Canadian backs trying to forge ahead, trying to make meters.
Let's go, Samoa.
Didn't look as crisp as they have earlier tonight on that particular set play.
Crouch. Behind! Set! Just a bit far away, guys. Let's just bring it up. So you got there and there. Just come up half step. Thank you.
Well, it was the blistering start from Canada tonight. As Samoa seemed to take a long while to get into the game.
Set!
Mafemi. To Ilagi bursting forward. Now Stanley. Was trying to get the ball back for Canada there, and now it's Evan Olmsted. Olmsted making his first start tonight, his test debut for Canada. Born in North Vancouver. Step moved to Australia at the age of 3, placing Parramatta 2 Blues in Australia.
8, stop. Oh, sorry. Number 8, White.
Abe Tuilagi is coming out of the game.
Sub on. Let's go, please, boys. I'm not going to stop. Let's go. Come on.
Referee asking Samoa to step things up.
Now.
Angus Gardner's had a good game tonight. Brian?
I think he's been terrific. I like his dialogue with the players, a couple conversations with the captains. He's tried to keep the game moving and flowing. He's been terrific.
Guys, you're too far away. Come up, Samoa. Up to the mark. Up, up. Thank you. Crouch!
Francis Savoy coming in to replace Tuilagi.
Set!
Yep. Drury with the put in at the Canadian scrum. Right on halfway. Picked up here by
they have numbers.
Carpenter. Canada with the break on here. They get up to the 22. Olmstead. Drury out to the right. Now it's Kyle Gilmore. This time they'll come to the left. Hirayama. Blevins. Now it's Moonlight. Minutes left as Hubert Bidens carries the ball forward. McCrory gets it out to Trainer. Still no way through. McCrory once again. This time off towards Tiedemann. Here's Blevins.
Move two! By advantage.
The referee playing advantage as McCrory gets it out to Hirayama. He tries the drop goal again with the advantage.
Good play by Hirayama. He knew they had advantage.
Two, roll away.
Took a shot, missed. Tackle was high. The referees awarded it. Canada has to make a decision here. And if I'm skipper, I know what I'm doing with James Pritchard on the field. You take your points, you square this thing up, and you go from there.
Sorry. Shot. Go for goal.
So they will go for goal. With James Pritchard having the chance to tie things up.
Guys, water on the side, thanks. On the side.
Taking off for
Samoa. I'm a call time off.
The substitute is number 20, Francis Savoy.
Pritchard with 8 points tonight. Tiedemann being helped off. Looks as though Sears Duru will come in. A hush around BMO Field. Pritchard to tie the game, and he's sent it wide. A couple of kicks missed now by James Pritchard, who started with 3 for 3 in the first half, but has now missed 2 second half kicks. And that's the difference right now.
Okay, can I play on? Time's off. Time off. Waiting for a substitution for Canada's blood.
Time is off the clock as Justice Sears Duru comes on with Andrew Tiedemann off for the blood bin. Another change for Samoa. Andrew Williams coming in.
No problem.
Replace Motu Matu at hooker.
Let's go.
In the arms of Harry Jones, who will kick high towards halfway. The chase is on.
Leader 23. Thank you.
Razor. said, Brian, heading in tonight, whatever the outcome, whatever the final score, you just wanted to see 80 minutes put together from Canada. Have you seen that?
I think the Canadian boys have played very, very hard, and they're on the outside looking in right now with about 6 minutes to go. They still have life.
Leave it!
But I think they've put in a very good effort, and it'd be nice to see them try and push this through in the end. But they'll be just as disappointed losing nonetheless. But it's been a decent effort by Canada.
Samoa just outside the 22. Williams trying to push forward here. Uriyama with the tackle. Samoa couldn't offload, but they have knocked it on. Sisduru. Canada with the advantage as Sisduru tries to make his way towards halfway. Inside from McCrory. Nathan Hiroyama looks to kick. Wide to the right. McKenzie manages to get there. And Canada has possession deep in the Samoa half. Great volley. Inside the 22. Canada could cross the line here for the try. They do. McKenzie brings BMO Field to its feet.
It almost all happened with the kick from Hiroyama, but the ball was tapped back, wasn't caught in the air, did not go forward. Hiroyama tries to put McKenzie away there. The ball would come back, Trainer flips it back, McKenzie sees the seam, and off he goes. And you can tell by the crowd reaction, they know he's going in.
Phil McKenzie gives Canada the 2-point advantage with less than 5 minutes to play and a very makeable kick for James Pritchard. It's Canada's second try of the night.
McKenzie known for his finish. And again, I can't say enough how tough he was defensively on Friday versus Tonga. But obviously going forward with ball in hand, he's world class. The Sail Shark puts Canada up as the clock ticks away, under 4 minutes to go.
62 minutes between points for Canada. Since it was 13-0. James Pritchard has missed the last two. This to make it a 4-point game. This time it's good from James Pritchard. And Canada leads by 20 points to 16 with the clock ticking down at BMO Field.
This may not change Canada's position. They're looking like they're in the 5-6 game on Monday against the Americans, but it may certainly euchre Samoa to get into the final of the PNC. Tonga may leapfrog them and get Fiji in the 1-2 game on Monday if Canada can hang on here.
Well, it may not change Canada's position, but it would certainly change their mindset.
Their psyche would change completely. They're going against the States, brimming with confidence. That flight back to Vancouver, it seems so much shorter. This has been a great effort by the Canadians, but it's not done yet.
Tonga winning earlier today against the US. Fiji winning against Japan. Fiji and Tonga ranked 1 and 2. Samoa could change that with a win.
And the great thing about that convert is Canada doesn't have to worry about Mr. Stanley right now and giving up a penalty. They're clear by 4 points. Samoa needs to try.
But over is good, and Sisduru has it as Canada move it out to the right. Blevins with a kick forward. Hiroyama will chase. McKenzie over there as well.
Number one in front of the kicker. Number one in front of the kicker. Yes.
Penalty Sears. Duru did not retreat. I think Canada number might have been better advised to keep the ball in hand on that. They had numbers. They had space.
Inside the final 2 minutes. As Stanley kicks long downfield. And a nervous 2 minutes ahead for this Canadian team and crowd.
Very much so.
Remember, Canada coming in ranked 18th. Samoa in the top 10 in the world, in 9th. The highest ranked of the teams in the Pacific Nations Cup. Samoa winning it in the line-out.
Manage. Okay, try manage. That's all right, there it is. Yep. South 15. Pulling down the victory in the line-out.
There you go. From Angus Gardner pulling down the lifter in the line-out. Yep. The reason for this
taking out the
penalty.
Jumper.
Stanley kicks to touch.
You would think Samoa are going to try and secure the line out and set up a driving maul, and then off the driving maul they could have a play on. They just huddled back at the 22. They're moving into the line out now.
Canada wins it at the line out, but Samoa will capitalize.
What I've seen is knock on by Canada first. You don't need anything different.
Nothing to add to that.
Yeah, yeah. So you've seen a fair try. Okay.
The try will be given. And Samoa breaking Canadian hearts late in this one. Canada won the line out, but then there was a knock on. Talofo gets the try. And with the clock ticking past the 80 minute mark, Samoa are in front. Stanley to add the extra two. It's not good from Stanley, but it is enough for Samoa to win the game by 1 point here at BMO Field with a try right on full time. Zakaria Talofo wins it after a brave Canadian effort.
Heartbreak for the Canadian.